Welcome to Nelson's Primary School. Dear students, today I am going to explain you the story Letter from a Grandchild. Before starting the story, we will drill some unknown words. So kindly drill along with me. Number 1. G-R-A and the Grand, P-A-Pa, Grandpa.
G-R-A-N-D, Grand, P-A-Pa, Grandpa. G-R-A-N-D, Grand, P-A-Pa, Grandpa.
Number 2, S-P-O-R-T-S, Sports, D-A-Y, Day, Sports Day. S-P-O-R-T-S, Sports, D-A-Y, Day, Sports Day. S-P-O-R-T-S, Sports, D-A-Y, Day, Sports Day. Number 3, A-N-N-U-A-L, Annual. A-N-N-U-A-L, Annual. A-N-N-U-A-L, Annual. Number 5, S-H-I-L-L-O-N-G, Shillong. S-H-I-L-L-O-N-G, Shillong. S-H-I-L-L-O-N-G, Shillong. Number 5, T-R-A-N-S-F-E-R, Transfer. T-R-A-N-S-F-E-R, Transfer. T-R-A-N-S-F-E-R, Transfer. Number 6, P-R-E-T-T-Y, Pretty. P-R-E-T-T-Y, Pretty. P-R-E-T-T-Y, Pretty. Number 7, L-A-W-N, Lawn. L-A-W-N, Lawn. L-A-W-N, Lawn. Number 8, K-I-T-C-H-E-N, Kitchen. K-I-T-C-H-E-N, Kitchen. K-I-T-C-H-E-N, Kitchen. Number 9, G-A-R-D-E-N, Garden. G-A-R-D-E-N, Garden. G-A-R-D-E-N, Garden. Number 10, B-A-C-K, Back, Y-A-R-D, Yard. Backyard. B-A-C-K, Back, Y-A-R-D, Yard. Backyard. B-A-C-K, Back, Y-A-R-D, Yard. Backyard. Number 11, C-A-N-D-L-E-S, Candles. C-A-N-D-L-E-S, Candles. C-A-N-D-L-E-S, Candles. Number 12, S-T-A-N-D-S, Stamps. S-T-A-N-D-S, Stamps. S-T-A-N-D-S, Stands. Number 13, P-I-N-E-S, Pines. P-I-N-E-S, Pines. P-I-N-E-S, Pines. Number 14, Cones. C-O-N-E-S, Cones. C-O-N-E-S, Cones. C-O-N-E-S, Cones. Number 15, T-A-S-T-E, Taste. T-A-S-T-E, Taste. T-A-S-T-E, Taste. Number 16, B-E-R-R-I-S, Berries. B-E-R-R-I-S, Berries. B-E-R-R-I-S, Berries. Number 17, C-R-A-Y-O-N-S, Crayons. C-R-A-Y-O-N-S, Crayons. C-R-A-Y-O-N-S, Crayons. Number 18, L-O-V-I-N-G-L-Y, Lovingly. L-O-V-I-N-G-L-Y, Lovingly. L-O-V-I-N-G-L-Y, Lovingly. Number 19, T-O-G-E-T-H-E-R, Together. T-O-G-E-T-H-E-R, Together. T-O-G-E-T-H-E-R, Together. Number 20, P-L-E-A-S-E, Please. P-L-E-A-S-E, Please. Now, students, I will tell you some meanings regarding this story. Number 1, Transfer. An act of moving something or someone to another place, organization, team. Means, some people who work in office, they get transferred. Those are working in bank or in government. Okay, so they get transferred from one place to another. Number 2, lawn. An area of grass, especially near to a house or in a park. Means Those are having tenements or a bungalow. They have garden in front of the house. It is known as lawn, where they can sit and have their tea. Number 3, kitchen garden. A garden or area where vegetables, fruits or herbs are grown for domestic use. Now, kitchen garden means some people have habit of growing fruits and vegetables or some small plants. That is known as kitchen garden. Number 4, backyard. An area at the rear of a house. Backyard means the place that is behind the house. Number 5, pine cone. Rounded woody fruit of a pine tree. It is one type of fruit. Now students, in this story, there is a grandpa and a grandchild whose name is Samir. Now here in the story, this boy is writing letter to his grandpa about how he is feeling and how much he is missing them. So to know about this, I will tell you the story. Now, once a boy wrote a letter to his grandpa because he was missing him. So he wrote in his letter that, "Grandpa, I am writing after a long time because I was busy with my sports day. I was busy playing games and I had sports day in my school and even I had my annual exam. So I could not write a letter. But now as I am free, I am writing a letter." So now we have moved to Shillong. He's saying now we have moved to Shillong because dad got transferred. So we had to move to Shillong. I and my parents love this place. He's saying I and my parents are loving this place because it's very beautiful. There are no cars on the road. There are very less cars. There is no traffic. Samir says there is no traffic on the road. Very less people are there. People are very less on the road. So he and his parents are loving this place. And at night, it is very cold over here. And during the day and night is very cold. So he loves this place. The night is lovely because there is no traffic and there is no people are very less. And day and night are very cold. And even the house which they are living, it is very pretty, it is very beautiful. Because it has a lawn in front of the house. It has a lawn in front of the house. And even a kitchen garden at the backyard. So he has a lawn and a kitchen garden at the backyard where they can grow vegetables, fruits and herbs. So Samir is saying he is very happy because he can sit there in the kitchen garden. And he has also made some good friends. And that friends have taught him how to make candle stands out of pine cones. So now Samir is saying he has learned how to make pine cones from candles out of pine cones. So he is very happy. And then he says that even my friends have made me taste different kinds of berries which we get only in Shillong. So he is very happy. Then he says now in the weekend his dad took him and his mother to Rome. So he took them to Ward's Lake and the Elephant's Fall last week. When dad had holiday, he's saying when my dad had holiday, he took us to Ward's Lake and Elephant's Fall. And that was also very beautiful. It looked very beautiful. Then he says, now you and grandma also come over here to Shillong. We will enjoy a lot. And I am missing you, both of you. So please come here. And he is sure that they will love this place. Then he says, thank you for the board game that his grandfather gave him. He told thank you. He wrote thank you in a letter for the board game. And he also told his grandpa to say thank you to his grandmother who gave him a box of crayons. Now on his birthday had gone, so he told his grandpa gave board game and grandmother gave box of crayon. So he says thank you to both of them. And he thanks grandma specially because she gave crayons with all the colors which he wanted. So he was very happy. Then he says, grandpa, I'm missing you and grandmother very much. I will be waiting for you to come to Shillong. So then he ends the letter writing, your lovingly, Samir. Now students, I will read the story once again. So kindly listen carefully. Dear Grandpa, it has been a long time since I wrote to you. I have been busy with my school sports day and annual exam. After that, as you know, we had to move to Shillong because of Dad's transfer. My parents and I love this place. There aren't many cars and people on the roads. The roads are very clean. I love it during the day, but the nights are very cold. The house we are living in is also very pretty. It has a lawn in the front and a kitchen garden in the backyard. I have some good friends here. They have shown me how to make candle stands out of pine cones. They have also made me taste the different berries you get here. Dad took us to see the Watts Lake and the Elephant's Fall last week. They are beautiful. You and Grandma should come to Shillong soon. We can have lots of fun together. I am sure you will love this place. Thank you for the board game you sent on my birthday. I really liked it. Also, please thank Grandma for the box of crayons she sent me. It has all the colors I wanted. Your lovingly, Samir. Okay, now students, I hope you understood. Now I will ask a few questions regarding this story. Number one, whom did the grandchild write a letter? Answer, the grandchild wrote a letter to his grandpa. Number two, with what was the grandchild busy? Answer, the grandchild was busy with his school sports day and annual exams. Number three, why did they have to move to Shillong? Answer, they had to move to Shillong because of his dad's transfer. Number four, what is not there on the road? Answer, there are not many cars and people on the road. Number five, how are the roads? Answer, the roads are very clean. Number six, how is the house they are living in? Answer, the house they are living in is very pretty. Number seven, what does the house have? Answer, the house has lawn in the front and a kitchen garden in the backyard. Number eight, what have his friends teach him? Answer, his friends has taught him how to make candle stands out of pine cones. Number 9, what has he tasted? Answer, he has tasted different berries. Number 10, where did Dad take them last week? Answer, last week Dad took them to see the Watts Lake and Elephant's Falls. Number 11, what did Grandpa send on his birthday? Answer, Grandpa sent a board game on his birthday. Number 12, why did he thank his grandma? Answer, he thanked his grandma for the box of crayons which had all the colors. Students, I hope you understood the story. Thank you.